your brother Frank, who you mentioned, you know, you were the youngest, he was the second youngest, yet still 8 years older. You really idolized him, even though he was very tough on you. He played for the Milwaukee Braves. You and your mom actually sat in the upper deck of a World Series game when he hit a home run. You had the chance to go in the clubhouse after the game, and you kind of credit that with making the World Series your dream. So when you finally got there, winning it, how did it compare to what you expected it to be like?
It was better than you could ever dream, but it's unreal. But 96 was such an emotional year. I mean, we were in first place most of the year, but in June I lose my brother Rocco, my oldest brother. He had a heart attack and died. And at the time, my wife called me. I was in Cleveland. We were in Cleveland for a doubleheader. And she calls me, she says, are you sitting down? And I thought for sure it was my brother Frank, because he had a massive heart attack years earlier. And, I know he was struggling. And it was my other brother who passed away. And then in October, right before game six, my brother Frank has this heart transplant. So it was really an emotional year. And you know, having won the World Series, and it just felt like this completed the circle in my career. Because I just felt, after witnessing the World Series, and I like to use the term, I said, it's no fun watching somebody else eat a hot fudge sundae. But when you get to that World Series and just taste that success, you never get tired of it.
And it's interesting, because you spoke in your book about how much you hated watching some of these teams celebrate championships before you'd actually won one yourself. You mentioned your brother Frank and needing the transplant. He was in the intensive care unit of the hospital when you won the World Series. Mm-hmm. It wasn't until the next morning that you spoke to him. Explain how neat it must have been to be able to follow through with your promise in terms of the ring.
It was, because he had given me the ring from the 58 team. Even though the Braves lost, you still get a ring. It's a championship ring, but it's not a world championship ring. And I had lost it, basically.
Must have been a great conversation.
Goodness gracious, it wasn't too good. So it was when, we won game five in Atlanta and came back, and was an off day now. I get a call the next morning that they found a match for my brother, and he's going to go in for the transplant. And I'm sort of stunned, because I hadn't slept, and I get a call from the doctor, and we had a workout, and I went over there to see him afterwards, and we chatted and whatever. It was unbelievable. I mean, this was like an out of body experience for me, just to have all these things going on at one time. I remember when we went over to the hospital, Reggie Jackson went over with me to see Frank, because he had, been friends. He's friends with Frank. And then I remember when we won the World Series that next day, which was Saturday, Frank called me. He says, well, kid, you did it, And you know what? You talked about my brother, and I idolized him, but I hated him too, because he just drove me so hard. He criticized me a great deal, and any article that's written about me didn't mean as much to me as when Frank would compliment me on something. And when he said, well, kid, you did it, that meant more to me than anything else. And it was never in my wildest dreams thinking that we're going to go to the World Series five more times.